It's the Joe Padula Show, Clarksville's conversation.
Absolutely.
Earlier this week, shot and killed his father, a child, a 15-year-old, who was abusing his mother. So, will he be going to jail or walking away free? Mellissa Marquais of Crime 411 will fill us in. Hey, what can you do this weekend that will have AirBnB arrest you for? Yeah. When trick-or-treating, how do you know which houses are occupied by a sex offender? Will there even be trick-or-treating this Halloween? We'll get into it. Plus, adults, why should you attend the second vampire ball? The Ladies of Envy Dark Dance events will cover it all. And how will you rewrite the story of a Naked South Nashville woman grabbing the butt of the Mapco gas station manager? We'll find out in today's Local News Mad Libs. So all of this and so much more will get covered today on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely. Woo! Ah, yes. Woo!
Philip Winkler says, hi, Joe.
Philip Winkler. What's up, Phil? How you doing, Phil?
Cold debonair.
Ah, the debonair. Well, this former soldier with the 2nd Brigade Combat Team Strike, 101st Airborne Division Air Assault, is ready. I'm ready for some real talk. I am ready for some real facts. I am ready for your real opinions. And I'm definitely ready to party with a purpose. Absolutely. I'm liking this new chair that moves. It swivels. It goes up. It goes down. It vibrates.
Mm-hmm. Is the butt part mesh?
Hummada, 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 hummada. Now I can't stand up.
Someone get him a towel.
It's hello. Wet.
Woo! All right. Well, I'll tell you what. We do got a lot to go over here, but on microphone, we got Bay. What's up, Bay?
Nothing much.
Bay, it's the last day of the week. I know we're not supposed to really mention days here or whatever, but yeah, it's Friday. I'm excited. I'm excited. Mm-hmm. It's Halloween weekend, Bay.
Mm-hmm.
You dressing up?
Nope.
Mellissa Marquais, what'd you come today as?
Crime 411 rep.
You're damn right. We're going to get into that story in just a moment. What's up, Adam Joseph?
Hey,
how you doing?
What's up, Joe? How's it going?
I like your Reagan Bush 84 hat.
Some guy asked me, he's like, you probably weren't alive back then. I go, I was born 3 years after, but I do remember the decade.
That's right. That's right. That's right. He was swimming during that election. You know what I mean? He was swimming around. Him and his brothers and sisters. Some didn't make it.
Life jackets.
What's up, Coach? How you doing?
What's up, P-Town? What's going on?
Coach, you got some advice, huh?
Yeah, I got a little advice.
Can you tease your advice?
It's all about intuition.
Intuition.
It's all about intuition.
He's a real coach. He's got a military background, law enforcement background, and coaching. And one of your students gave you a nice compliment that I ran into.
Really?
Patricia.
Hey.
Yeah, you know Patricia.
Yeah, she used to run cross country for me, and she is a scholar student, speak about 2 or 3 languages.
How fast can she be? She's like this tall.
She's a monster. She's like one of. She does not quit. Does not quit.
That's what's up, Patricia.
You would be very impressed.
Little person track. I like that.
Track
little,
cross
little
country.
People track.
Yeah.
I like that.
Short distance.
Oh, short distance. Oh, there he goes. There he goes. Look who else is on camera, dressed up as a witch. What's up, Sonia?
Hey, Joe. How are you?
Sonia, you guys got a big event going on tomorrow. We're going to get into that in just a little bit.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, no doubt.
Fun.
Miss you. It's good to have you back.
Thanks. I miss being here.
And we're going to play some Local News Mad Libs for your return.
Awesome.
Yes. It's adult Mad Libs. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
All right. So, let's get into this, all right? Oh, I got to turn you off, Glitch Mob. Boom. So, earlier this week, a 15-year-old shot and killed his father, who was abusing his mother. So, will the 15-year-old be going to jail or will he be walking free? Well, Mellissa Marquais of Crime 411 will fill us in now. on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely. Hey, don't forget to click subscribe, hit that like button, leave your comments. We'll get to them and definitely help us out and share this video as we continue to fight the shadow ban. Crime 411, great show. Check it out on YouTube. All the links are in this live video feed. And hey, if you're listening on the iHeartRadio, if you want to see what we're seeing, just go to that Facebook page or YouTube and boom, there we are. All right, so Crime 411, what's your mission with Crime 411?
Raise awareness on things, report news from a compassionate, empathetic viewpoint, and not just...
Did you say empathetic or pathetic?
Empathetic.
Empathetic, good, good. Pathetic. We're going to give a pathetic point of view on things. And yeah, I mean, your channel's growing very, very rapidly. It's very nice to see. And on this story here, it's interesting because the 15-year-old, this comes out of Georgia.
Yep.
Give us the five W's. Who, what, when, where, why?
So, Appling, Georgia, a 15-year-old boy, Tucker, I wrote his name down because I keep forgetting, Tucker Gales. He shot and killed his father after years and years and years of physical and verbal abuse that was dished out to him, to his mom, and he said he had enough of his father abusing his mom, and he killed him.
Well, okay, let's back it up a little bit, if you don't mind.
Let's do it.
Okay? If this guy kept on abusing and abusing the kid and the mom, was he ever reprimanded or arrested for such abuse?
So, let me refer to my notes.
Oh, you got notes.
I do, because this one's detailed.
And a piece
and
of paper that looks like
wrong.
You sat on right over here.
I did. Look at that. Okay, so from what I read, this has been going on since back in 2011, right? Constant abuse, constant physical abuse. Cops were called, you know, numerous times to come out about it, but there was never enough physical evidence for them to do anything until 2017. And in 2017...
Well, if the kid's 15 years old now, so this started when he was like six, okay.
Yeah, so he was a little guy. And this year, actually...
And explain the abuse, if you don't mind.
Well, I'll give you an example. March 20th, the father, Wesley is his name, Wesley Gales, he was charged with cruelty to children and family violence and battery. He punched his wife in the eye, kicked her in the head, busted her nose, and admitted it. When officers came out, they could clearly see that there was an altercation, and they asked him about it, and he said, yeah, this is what happened. So they right. arrested him. She took him back, unfortunately.
She took him back. Well, that seems to be a pattern.
Seven times is the usual amount of times that a woman or someone in an abusive relationship will go back to their abuser before they finally leave.
Why that number? And coach, have you ever heard of such a thing?
Nope.
No, right? I don't understand that pattern.
I do.
What? Why? What do you think it is?
It's a cycle of abuse, and it's having been through it, not physically, but having been through it myself years ago. Like, I used to always be one of those people that would say, why doesn't she just leave?
Right.
And then I became one of them, and I never said it again.
Why? Why didn't you leave?
Well, for one, I had, at that time, I had a investor. I was doing music for a living, and we had an agreement. I was in the middle of producing an album, and the guy that I was with was my partner on it. And so if I were to leave that situation, I would have been in breach of contract with the investor. And he knew it.
What do you think this situation with this in Georgia? Why do you think she kept on accepting this guy who is who's been documented for going to jail for beating her and the kid?
Well, oh. I'll tell you, you know, in a lot of situations when it comes to domestic violence and abuse like that, it's such a gradual process that it's you don't recognize it until it's already so far gone that you're like, I am a shell of the person that I used to be. Like, what happened to my life? And it's very covert a lot of the time.
Okay.
A lot of the times it doesn't start physical, right? And it's mental and it's verbal. And so that cycle of abuse is, okay, here he comes again. It's a big blow up, right? And then it's, I'm sorry, I'm never going to do it again. Then it's another honeymoon stage and everything is great. And then it's like, oh, they're changing. They're finally coming around and this is going to be different. And then, boom,
but in reality,
it's
manipulation.
It's complete manipulation.
Right.
Yes.
And it goes both ways for guys and girls.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Essentially, they make you comfortable with your new norm.
Uh-huh.
And now this chaos is your new norm. So like she said, it's not as visible, as easily recognizable on a daily basis because you become comfortable with it.
Right.
It's no different than not that he is this, what I'm about
no,
to say.
No, go ahead.
It's no different when you're dealing with a sex offender. They start that grooming stage,
yep.
And they get them comfortable, and then they finally make their move. It's the same thing of a person who abused women or a woman that may abuse men, vice versa. They make you comfortable first.
It's also with their chaos. It also goes back to her saying about the verbal stage of it is they get that mindset in you that, like, you leave me, there's nobody else for you to protect you or have that, you know, that home for you or something like that. So
and
it does,
they will cut off your resources.
And they will cut off your resources because people are manipulative like that in that kind of relationship.
So nonetheless.
They will cut off your resources. They'll keep you from your family. I remember my ex would take parts off my car so that I couldn't leave. And he would say, oh, the car's broken. And I had no idea what was going on.
What do you mean? Like what kind of parts?
Just whatever, you know.
Hey, your tire's missing. I'm sorry. I don't know what happened.
The alternator would be, you know.
An alternator?
Or just whatever. And then I remember one time, he said the car was stolen. And I was like this. And at this time, I started realizing what was happening, right? And I saw him on the phone making a police report that the car was stolen. And I picked up the phone in the other room because this was back before cells, right? And it was his house phone. I was like, wow.
Wow.
And the light bulb went off.
Man, the only time in a relationship she lied to me, she told me it was big. That's crazy.
she talked about your dining room table? Like, what was she?
His head,
his ego. She's talking about my ego.
Wow, I thought that table was.
I got a question. Did he ever?
Thanks,
did he ever tell you, no one will want you but me?
All the time.
Yeah.
No one
and
will want you but
that.
Me.
Or have you said this?
What a douchey move.
I remember my father always telling my sisters and my nieces, if I can't have you, no one will.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
That sounds creepy.
If anyone ever tell you that, you should leave.
Right? Yeah. With their eyes wide open.
If they make that comment and they own three cats, you should leave.
And they own three cats. But it is true, though. And a lot of people stay in these relationships, too, because the most dangerous time for someone in that relationship is when they leave.
Yeah. You know who's the scariest one of all? Ever see Wedding Crashers?
Yes.
I will find you.
The girl with the red hair. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I loved her.
Oh, my God. But anyway, back to this story. Okay? October 28th, all right? So this 15-year-old who has experienced this, along with the mother that we just established this scenario, the father, okay, Wesley Jordan Gales, 66 years old,
not anymore.
Well, gets shot by the 15-year-old with a .22 caliber.
Yep.
Why? What was the situation? Bring us there.
They didn't really put out what led to it in this particular situation, so I'm sure that there must have been some sort of an altercation and he was sick and tired of watching his mother be abused, obviously, but they didn't give out any information, probably because it's still an ongoing investigation.
Okay.
So I don't know. But I do know that that he was released on a signature bond.
So he's out. So
he's out.
Right. He got charged. Okay.
He's released from jail until the trial. And there is a lawyer that actually stepped up to the plate and reached out and is representing him at no charge because he said he feels as though this was a justified homicide. And I've never heard that term before. And I wish Lawyer Wayne were here right now to kind of explain that to
me.
But
pro bono.
Pro bono. So that speaks volumes to what he must have gone through at home for somebody to take their time and their profession and put it on the line like that for somebody who just killed someone, right?
Mm-hmm. Essentially, come down to that person has received so much trauma that they acted out of a traumatic event, almost like a crime of passion.
Yeah.
I'm looking at this guy's record, the father's, this year, okay, in March. Okay, he was arrested for cruelty to children and a family of violence battery.
September again.
All right, yep. He was accused of punching his wife, Deborah, okay, in the eye, kicking her in the head, throwing a DVD player down the hall. Who still has DVD players? But anyway, that's
and
besides the
point.
And
kicking her in the privates.
Yeah? Like a field goal?
That's God. That's awful.
After the responding officers noted blood coming from Deborah Gales' nose and marks on her body, they questioned Wesley, who admitted the verbal and physical altercation. And then, in September, Deborah, she called 911, and her husband allegedly threatened to shoot her son in the head. She added that her husband also, yes, like you said, Mellissa, kicked her in the privates.
Horrible.
Yeah, so...
that answered my question. I was going to ask where the firearm came from. Was it the father's? Did the son find it? I was wondering where he got the...
That's a good question. That's
a great question.
As a 15-year-old.
Right.
Like, where do you come across with that, you know? So, but then when you said... Father threatened to shoot his. I'm assuming that the abusive father had
the 22.
Yeah.
How ironic how that karma worked out for him, right?
Yeah.
So, what do you think? Is this kid going to get off?
You know, it's hard to say. I don't know. I guess it really depends on the extent of the abuse and the history there, right? To, like you had said earlier, to build up a case about that trauma that he had experienced throughout his whole life, and to warrant whether or not it, like he said, it was a crime of passion or he snapped or, you know, whatever the case may be. But I would really, personally, for me to guess and say whether or not I think he'll get off, I would really need to know a lot more about the history of what went on in that house.
Coach, you've dealt with stuff like this.
How old is he?
He's 15.
There's so many factors I would even probably guess, but I would say one is going to go by the last time that the abuse occurred.
Uh-huh.
Last time he was visible seeing it.
Yeah.
The last time he experienced it or had contact with that person.
Right.
And what was his frame of mind at the time of the incident?
Okay. Uh-huh. Interesting.
Intent is always number one.
Bae, you sat there, you took in all the information, you got the final say. What's your predictions?
Yeah, I think he's going to get up.
You think so?
Yeah, because that father been doing that for years, and ain't no telling what he done said to him and what done did to him, you know.
And all you need is one juror, right?
I think so.
Right, is it?
Well, I guess it depends on what the what you're facing, if it's life or if it's, I don't know.
Yeah, interesting.
Crime I've never heard of a justified homicide in my life. Have you? I mean, people say it, but legally, I've never heard that used.
Lawyer Wayne,
he's
justified,
here? Perfect
yeah,
timing.
Justified homicide, Lawyer Wayne.
Yep.
What is that? Huh? Can you explain that a bit?
I mean, somebody needed to kill it.
Okay.
Call Lawyer Wayne.
Oh, Lord.
Lawyer Wayne.
That went straight to the point.
Well, we'll find
What's
out.
What's up, killer?
We'll find out. Crime 411, their link is right in this description. Okay, go check them out. Mellissa, nice job that you're doing with help spreading the word and stories and relaying these people's messages.
Well, thanks for having me on all the time.
Too easy. All right, well, coming up, what can you do this weekend that will have Airbnb arrest you? Yeah. Well, also, when trick-or-treating, how do you know which houses are occupied by a sex offender? I got the answers. And also, will there even be trick-or-treating this Halloween? What can you expect at your door? You know, what the hell is going on locally? That's next on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
Salutations.
I'm going.
This is Casey Bryant with Local Clarksville. Don't forget to download our app to find local places to eat, shop, and play. You're listening to the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
Water dogs. Water dog scuba and safety. There's a whole world to discover underwater, and at Water Dog Scuba and Safety, they're here to help you explore it. Veteran and locally owned, and whether you're already an expert diver or beginner seeking adventure, Water Dogs offers private and scheduled dive trainings for all ages. Get those kids, but no dogs. Go check out their Facebook page. Look at their underwater videos. 681 North Spring Street, downtown Clarksville. Go say hello to Rich and Cecil and the team at Water Dog Scuba and Safety.
Aloha, Clarksville. This is Dar, owner of Kimo's Hawaiian Bar and Grill, now located at 125 Franklin Street, downtown Clarksville. Chef Gracie has prepared authentic Polynesian food and drinks that will have you feeling like you're eating on the Big Island of Hawaii, all while here in Clarksville. The Hawaiian chicken has been called the best damn chicken in the state. You gotta try her Calbee short ribs, and of course the authentic Kalua pork is gonna remind you of the islands. Her mahi-mahi is perfectly cooked every time. Happy hour is Monday through Friday from 2 to 5 p.m. with both food and drink specials. Tuesday nights is kid nights with a $5 kid meal along with Hawaiian crafts. Every Wednesday at 7 is Kimo's Big Prize Trivia with a $100 gift card giveaway for the first place team. Fridays and Saturdays, live music inside and out. And those 21 and up, you're going to want to order Casey's Bahama Mama, our number one drink. Check out all the pictures and video on Kimo's Facebook page and definitely come on in and experience Kimo's Hawaiian Bar and Grill. Aloha, y'all.
Hey, this is Teresa Jarvis, mayor of Oak Grove, and Oak Grove loves Joe Padula. But Joe, come on now. Enough with the Cat West jokes. Absolutely.
What can you do this weekend that will have you arrested by Airbnb? Also, when you're trick-or-treating, how do you know which houses are occupied by the sex offender? Will there also even be trick-or-treating this Halloween in your neighborhood? the hell is going on locally. That's now on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely. Make sure to click like, subscribe, leave your comments, and definitely help us out and share this video now. All right? Much appreciated. Okay. What's up, Lawyer Wayne?
What's up, Joe?
Ever been arrested by Airbnb?
I have not.
They have arrest authority?
I don't know. I guess so. Because check this one out. This is quite the...
Just locally or...
Airbnb says that it may take legal action against anyone who violates the company's ban on house parties at its Nashville listings and Tennessee listings this holiday weekend.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm.
Legal action. Oh, yeah. No.
Yeah, the company recently announced that it would prohibit one-night reservations this weekend in Nashville and across Tennessee to protect hosts amid concerns over the pandemic.
They might got the Rona. They might leave Rona all over your Airbnb.
They might
if you're
what?
Concerned about Rona on your Airbnb, why are y'all renting your house out on Airbnb?
Okay. Lawyer Wayne, I hear
Shouldn't you sanitize it anyways?
Okay.
Whether it be for one night or multiple?
They ain't sanitizing nothing.
So, nonetheless, the spokesperson for Airbnb said that the company informed guests with reservations of two or more days over the holiday weekend that they could be removed from the property they rent or legal action could be taken if they violate the company's ban on parties. Now, the ban on parties, I had to go digging for this, so I went to their website. It was right there. The ban on the parties went into effect... Okay, in August, and their website says a ban on all parties and events at Airbnb listings include a cap on occupancy at, guess the number, Bay?
20.
20?
I was going to say 6.
6?
11.
11?
5.
Team Envy?
6.
6? 16.
That's okay. Too many.
16.
Anything over 16 is a party. Please tell me there's a very long description of what counts as a party.
Nope.
Loud? No? Is it just 16 or more people?
It's just 16 or more.
So if it's less than 16, it ain't a real party.
Why do you think Airbnb chose to cap it at 16? Why that specific number?
They probably took a poll amongst their office workers and said, what's the best party you've ever been to? What was the lamest? Uh-huh. They took an average and said, man, I went to this party. There's only 15 people there, max. Wasn't even a real party.
You could take 7 people smoking crack together, and they said that's a hell of a party. So, oh, I think we need to reduce them numbers.
Like, is there a difference maker if there's 15 as opposed to 16?
Plumbing wise, yes. Yeah. I own property. You want to keep people at 5 and under.
Man.
You know what it's like to unplug a toilet?
Ever been to a house party with just like 5 people though? It's so lame.
But no,
you can only talk to somebody for so long while they're dressed as a cat. But you know,
that's how you get the come up. That's how you get your next date. But when it get over 5, now you're looking at plumbers, especially if they're drinking coffee. See, that's another problem right there. Toilet paper is going to disappear.
The last party I went to, it was lame. The last lame party I went to, it was about 10 people.
Yeah.
Okay, this was in 2005, I believe it was.
And you're playing the game where you take a drink and then you pour some of your drink in and it gets around to you and it still tastes like your drink. There's not enough people to even mix it up, you know?
You shouldn't be sharing.
What games are you playing?
COVID passing
games?
Yeah.
Bay, that year, it was Wedding Crashers came out, the movie Wedding Crashers, and I went as Owen Wilson.
Okay.
And I got the wig, and I even got this witch's nose that matched my skin color because he's got that nose.
Wow.
Right? And I got the suit, and I walk into the party. And I'm like, oh, I got this. I got the pop culture icon costume of the year. And I walk in, they go, hey, look, it's Rod Stewart. And I was just Rod Stewart for the rest of the night.
So Dar wants me to tell you something.
What's up, Dar?
So, hey, Dar. He said the Airbnb issue is about people renting houses for one night and people do thousands of dollars in damage. It's not about Corona. It's about people destroying property.
Now, but they implemented this, and I hear what Dar's saying. That's a good point, Dar, of Kimo's Hawaiian Grill, by the way. Great place. Section 120, 125 Franklin Street downtown. They started this in August, though, and according to the website, into a battle, the pandemic.
Pandemic.
Right. But, okay, I could see then.
Yeah, but still, why 16?
They figure
15 people won't destroy it, but 16 people.
Maybe
will.
It's based on square footage.
I don't know, but what if you got a really big house? You're a really big mansion Airbnb. Yeah. And you got 16 rooms.
Then five people's really lame.
Then everyone's got to sleep alone.
You ain't Airbnb.
And that's a lame party.
It's right. A really lame party.
Do kids count, I wonder, 12 and under?
What about dogs?
Yeah. That's a good point. Do kids count?
I can only invite like three people over.
Yeah. Limit? What if Lawyer Wayne goes get an Airbnb? He's married. He's got nine kids. Literally, he has nine kids. Lawyer Wayne, you can't invite only two people.
Anybody like you and, I don't know, probably Coach Chestnut.
Hey.
Maybe Bay.
I'm not going to that party.
Does that include employees that you may hire to come to the party?
Yeah, caterers.
Or strippers.
Ooh. Oh. See, we need to check this for loopholes. Oh, these aren't partiers.
No,
see,
they are here working.
Passing out drinks.
Totally need a loophole.
That's a good point. Yeah.
Waiter.
That's hired catering.
That's right.
Right.
What you eating?
I paid a minimum wage in beer.
At that point, we don't call them loopholes. They're called poop holes.
Oh, God.
Poop holes.
So bad.
When trick-or-treating, how do you know which houses are occupied by a sex offender?
Lights are off.
Well, the Tennessee Department of Correction, they said that it'll be conducting its Operation Blackout in an effort to protect children from sex offenders.
Why has it got to be black?
Around Halloween.
I'm always trying to keep the black man down.
They need to rename that.
Well, I think Operation African American Out would be even more offensive. Yeah. Get out! So, T-Doc, they'll be conducting this compliance checks with more than 38,000 registered sex offenders this year.
Uh-huh.
And sex offenders will be reminded of a very specific set of rules to follow. One, be in your homes by 6 p.m.
Oh, they need to be.
Oh, no.
They should make it 5.
Oh, they got a curfew.
They should just have their own island.
You cannot have any Halloween decor. Mm-hmm. Can't decorate.
Only not Christmas even candy decorations.
Corn. Only Christmas decorations.
Right. So if you see somebody with Christmas decorations out already, they're probably a sex offender.
Well, on the upside, they get to save on the electricity. They have to keep their porch light off all night. Mm-hmm. So you got that. Not distributing Halloween candy.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Not even at the corner.
They didn't say anything about food. Like,
right.
Like a
apples,
pie.
Apples, yeah. Bananas.
The ones with
nuts,
the razors.
Lame yeah. Stuff.
Oh, my gosh. You remember that?
Mm. No, it wasn't a real thing.
Yes, it was.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was.
It wasn't a real thing, but then after the stories came out, it then became,
it became a
real thing.
Fake, like, prank thing.
Okay, then I'm calling my dad out right now because
yes, he
would
lied
cut
to
all
you.
The Snickers in half. And all the Kit Kats and all the good candy.
He got
to
duped
check
by
for razors.
Fake news. That was the beginning of fake news.
No, he
all
didn't
the
get
witches were hiding stuff
news.
In the candy
we
to get
did.
Us kids.
He wanted the candy.
No,
put meth in
I
it.
I check it. Make sure there's no razors in it.
Yep. Yeah.
Also, registered sex offenders are not allowed to attend any Halloween functions. Mm.
That's right.
Hallelujah night, harvest festivals, etc.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. They can't even go to the anti-Halloween party
nope.
Things.
Mm-hmm. Can't do it.
You can neither participate nor refuse to participate.
They're
well,
also,
they have to be home, right?
Apparently.
Yeah, curfew.
Costume-wise, not allowed to dress up as Jared Fogle of Subway with a shirt saying, eat fresh or free foot-long special. No, that's not on there. That's a joke.
In this subdivision I used to live in, I ain't going to say what it was, but it's someone in our subdivision used to go by and put a little red dot on the mailboxes where all the sex offenders live. We had three.
A red
subject.
Dot?
Yep.
Really?
Spread on their mailbox.
That's how they find each other.
Here, let's take a look. Okay.
The sex offender registry is basically just a dating site at this point.
Wow. Yeah. They also got this thing here, okay? And then the website is linked into the video screen here. All right. Let's see what we got for Clarksville.
There's a that one and a
Coach, what's your address?
777-9311.
Okay, let's see.
Boohoo Lane.
Whoa.
Oh, man. Is that all the sex offenders?
Whoa.
Oh, it's a lot.
But some of them could be like they were 18 and the girlfriend was 17 and the mom
matter.
Got mad, right?
If they're on the list.
They're still on the list.
Right. I know.
Lawyer Wayne, you've some of your clients might be these blue dots, right?
Not my clients.
Oh, they get off?
Yeah, I haven't had any.
Not literally.
This is a bad
that's joke. That's the reason. That's the reason you hired me is to stay off that list.
So, yeah, that, wow. It looks like my face freshman year of high school.
It's a lot of people.
Yeah.
I will say that Montgomery County had more child sex abuse open cases than Davidson County for several years.
Interesting.
That's because they can't close a case.
lawyer rivalry going on there?
I'm not doing it. That could have went so many different ways.
So, yeah, they do have this interactive search map. If you want to go, okay, the link is in this video description, okay? So just check it out, and you can narrow it down to your neighborhood.
Let's go to Laura Wayne's house.
Problem is we're so close to Kentucky. They come across the border here.
The border.
Oh, you blame it on the Kentuckians?
Yeah.
Go over by...
Age of consent up there, 17, down here.
Go over
take
by
two.
Downtown.
No, I can't move any closer because then it starts showing names. I don't want to do that. You know what I mean?
Does it show with our senses?
It does give a report.
Do it, Joe.
It gives a lot of information.
It does.
But do it, Joe.
Names, age, preferences.
I can't.
Do it.
All right, moving forward.
Do it.
Will there even be trick-or-treating this Halloween?
So what's our numbers looking like? Well, you did a good research.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm glad you brought that up because...
That was good information. I like how you did that.
You know, math. Right, math. What do we got? Here in Montgomery County?
We got a little over, 500 cases?
Yeah, so that would make ours 0.24% of the population.
Yes.
Right. And Davidson County, 0.38% of the population.
If I recall right.
And, Tennessee, 0.35% of the population, which is less than 1% of the population with active COVID cases.
I just don't want to be a part of that percent.
Yeah, I mean, hey, be safe. Be safe. Do what you got to do.
When the kids come, just throw the candy at them.
But live your life.
Don't let them get near you.
Well, here's what CDC is saying. The CDC, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, mm-hmm. They list participating in traditional trick-or-treating, where treats are handed to children who go to the door-to-door,
right,
as a high-risk activity. Mm-hmm. Well, most Americans are saying F that. A recent Harris poll says 80% of families surveyed says that trick-or-treating is on the list of things to do for Halloween, despite the CDC saying that the tradition may not be safe this year.
You know what else is on the list?
What's that?
Dar at Chemo's has CBD-infused cocktails at Chemo's tomorrow night.
Look at Dar getting the shameless plug
I know.
In there.
Dar.
Dar shoehorning that
plug
in there.
I'm just working that for him. He's a good guy.
Shout out to South Ridge Subdivision. I like y'all.
Nah, Dar's good people.
I like about Dar. Free shots when they do.
Red Hot's in a slingshot. That's all you need. Well, keep the kids away.
Some physicians say that you can limit COVID-19 exposure by making sure that your trick-or-treating group stays small. And also, if you're going to hand out candy to trick-or-treaters, physicians recommend making grab-and-go bags to leave on your doorstep. Get out of here. Everyone's going to grab all the bags.
Ain't nobody doing all that.
Listen.
That's why you got to have the Red Hot and the slingshot to try to take to you. Pop them.
That sounds like fun, actually.
Did anybody used to snatch bags and run on Halloween?
Do you guys remember the house that always gave, the big Kit Kat and, the big Babe Ruth, right?
That's what a pervert don't we live.
The neighbor.
The full size.
I remember the house that gave pennies. You were like, seriously?
You would go and, change your outfit just to go back to that friggin' house.
Heck yeah, you would. And be like, seriously, you gave me pennies. What is this?
Pennies. Or my favorite, those marshmallow peanuts.
Or Bible passages. I've had people put Bible passages in my son's trick-or-treat bag. I'm like, what is this?
Amen.
Where's the Kit Kat?
Suffer not the witch to live.
How about the jerks that gave peanuts? Actual peanuts.
Right
out their hand.
Peanuts.
As they crotch.
Hey, where's Halloween candy you ever got? What was it?
It was free.
It was free. You know what? Well, here we are complaining about free food and candy. Good call, Bay.
Bay counting the economical effects of it.
CDC says that you can make trick-or-treating a tradition safer by wearing a mask. Of course, they want you to wear these masks. So some doctors suggest that if your costume involves a mask, that does not sufficiently cover the face to consider skipping that part altogether and just wear a mask. And
so
not
if you were in a doctor's outfit, that mask don't count?
You know what? Doctors should be a high percentage of trick-or-treaters.
Nurses,
year.
Doctors, things like that.
EMTs.
I disagree. I went trick-or-treating as a ninja for 4 years because my mother wouldn't buy no costume.
Yeah.
You just put the t-shirt hole over your face and tie it off.
What up, my ninja?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
A ghost outfit would probably work. You know, get the sheet over the entire body.
That sounds KKK.
I wore the ghost.
It's not a pointy one.
Yeah, the pointy
ghost.
It's
got to have a rounded top. Be careful.
No.
Who are you this year? I'm a Grand Kegel.
Right.
A Kegel. Kegel. Kegel is something much different.
Ooh. It's a good exercise.
Burn calories by doing Kegels. Isn't that right, Mellissa Marquais of Crime 411?
I don't even know what a Kegel is.
Really?
I have no idea what you're all talking about.
Ladies, you know what a Kegel is,
right? Don't say that on air.
It's right.
Don't say it. You need to get Kegeling.
I have to Google this. I have a feeling I don't want to know what y'all are talking about.
You should know. You should know.
What a segue.
This could improve your dating.
Hey, if you're listening, if you're watching on the live video feed, inform Mellissa Marquais what a Kegel is.
All Please right? don't.
All right, type it in the comments and hey, tell us what you think about all this stuff going on for Halloween locally and let us know your thoughts and comment and definitely share. Appreciate it. All right, coming up, adults, why should you attend the second vampire ball? Oh, yeah. The ladies of Envy Dark Dance events, they're going to cover it all next on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely. Woo!
Realtor at RE/MAX North Star. So feel free to add your comments and don't forget to share it on your timeline. Bae's my favorite. Absolutely.
So one of the most stressful things to do is buy or sell a house. Well, that all changes. Why? Shelly Holiday, Realtor, RE/MAX North Star. She eliminates the stress parts of buying or selling a house. She'll work that deal. She networks. She knows how to do it. She's Shelly Holiday, Realtor RE/MAX North Star. And you want her. I'll tell you what. Just go to her Facebook page. She's Shelly Holiday, Realtor RE/MAX North Star. Just do it. Click like, send her a message.
Attention brick and mortar business owners in Clarksville and Fort Campbell. A poor decision about the way you choose to advertise can cost you big time. The sad truth is, businesses try all kinds of advertising and burn right through their profits. Or they waste their precious time trying to learn complicated online geeky things. Wiz Advertising has used its proven six-step system for the past 14 years to help Clarksville businesses get matched with just the right new customers. Learn more at wizads.com. That's W-H-I-Z-Z. ADS.com.
The following is a paid advertisement for legal services.
Hello, Clarksville. Lawyer Wayne here. Yes, I am a real lawyer, and yes, I have 9 kids. Do you know what the number one complaint about lawyers is? It's not how much they cost or even how good a job they do. It's that they don't return phone calls. Well, if you go to lawyerwayne.com, I've got my cell phone number on there. You put it in your phone, and if you need a lawyer, text me. You can come down to my office at 120 South 2nd Street. We can talk about your case. I offer free consultations. Know your rights, know your options. LawyerWayne.com.
This is Lawyer Wayne. Check me out at LawyerWayne.com and check me out on TikTok at Lawyer Wayne. You're listening to The Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
Ah, yes. Coming up, a lot of Halloween events. A lot to do. I mean, you got a lot for all different ages. I'll be emceeing at O'Connor's. That's your costume contest. Kimo's Hawaiian Grill, talking about Dar. They got stuff for the kids. They got the Kiki Corner, which is a Hawaiian for Kids Corner, where they get to do all these cool things. And they got some shot specials, too, for you adults. Right? And also, they got the second annual Vampire Ball. So the ladies of Envy Dark Dance Events, they're here to cover it all. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the ladies.
Woo-hoo!
It's good to see you, Kev. What's up, Sonia?
Here,
get close to those mics. Get her right up on those mics. Yes, there they are. Yes.
And we brought Brittany.
What's up, Brittany? How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, good, good. Here, Brittany, let me get you more on camera. All right, there we go. One-man show today. One day, intern Shane will take over the reins. I can't wait.
Master Shane.
Master Shane. Oh, boy, does he wish he was here today.
He'd be hugging everybody.
He's such a, like a... And intern Shane, we love you. Don't get me wrong. Austin P, let's go P. But he likes requesting hugs from girls, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, he's that
guy. It's usually the other way around. Everybody always wants to hug Shane.
Yeah, yeah, because like he's got the same size boobs as they do.
No.
No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Aww.
Shane, I'm kidding. No, I love intern Shane.
Everybody loves intern Shane.
All right, so we got the link to the event. The Vampire Ball, the second annual. The link is within this video feed. If you want to check it out, just definitely go to that link. I'm on the page here, too. All right. Okay, Vampire Ball. What is it?
Here
we go. Oh. Go for it,
Sonia.
So it's
our second annual Vampire Ball. We held this last year as well. And it's formal vampire attire. You can come as something else if you'd like, but the only people eligible to do our costume contest for Vampire King and Vampire Queen are vampires.
Okay, so come as a vampire. Now, doesn't matter what type of vampire.
Nope.
No.
Yeah.
We've already seen some really, really interesting costumes. Like
explain.
Traditional Bram Stoker's vampire, like
Dracula,
old school to Blade.
Yeah.
So, everybody's getting really creative, like Buffy the Vampire Slayer, the original.
Tie dye vampire, I think there's
a hippie vampire.
Yeah,
I'm not being a vampire.
We have so many things that people have already gone, like, got my costume, we're so excited, and it was so big last year, we decided we'll just do this every year, and now it's. We assume it's going to be the biggest party this year for Halloween.
And so. You guys are going to be at the warehouse. What time you guys open the doors over there?
At 8 p.m.
Okay, so 8 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what if you don't want to dress up as a vampire?
Yeah, you can dress up as whatever you want.
Just dress up as whatever. Yeah. Somebody's already got a costume. They can still go there.
Yep.
Yep.
Okay. Now, all right. Now, for the contest, how's the judging going to work?
So we're going to give numbers to, people that qualify that are in formal or really done out vampire or vampire related.
Yeah, if
costumes.
They're crappy vampires, you'd be like, I'm sorry.
I mean, they got a shot, but you know.
Like, hey, you bought the fangs, get it. Right, right.
But so we'll do it by numbers, and then people can come and cast their vote at the DJ booth, and then, at 11 p.m., we'll crown the king and queen. We got prizes from the Upstairs Emporium and a bunch of local vendors. So we got some really cool, like, local business weird stuff for them.
Now, what steps have you taken to ensure that there's no Russian interference with the voting process? No, everything's on the up and up?
Okay. We're going to dance, and that's,
That's what's up. And, yes, performance-wise, what do you guys, what's the plan?
So we have a couple circus acts that are going to be going on. We have our hippie vampire girl is going to be doing hula hoop.
Okay, good.
We got pole dancing, chair dance, belly dance with a bloodbath. Like,
what do you mean a bloodbath?
That's exactly what it sounds like.
No.
Yes.
Oh, Sonia, that's going to be you?
It's not me.
It's actually going to be Courtney, if you remember her.
Courtney. Oh, yeah. In case you didn't know, this is sign language for back problems. Yeah. Right. Bloodbath. All right. So, man, and how long are you guys going to be partying for over there?
We were hoping the daylight savings would give us an extra hour to party, but most bars aren't doing that. So it's 8 p.m. to 2 a.m. if they'll,
Let me tell you.
Maybe
if people are there spending the money, they'll take advantage of that daylight saving, okay? Nice.
Yeah, it is the warehouse, so.
It is. Over there on McClure Street, okay? And again, if you need any more information, just go to this link that's in the video feed. And the Vampire Ball, second annual.
Yeah. I was going to say one more thing, Joe.
Yeah, what's up, Sonia?
So we have a ticket link up right now.
Okay.
And your tickets in advance are $15 through today. And tomorrow at the door, they're $20. So it's really a good idea to get your tickets in advance if you want to save a little money.
Good for you guys. Good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Have you guys been just fiending for events, right?
We've actually been doing them nonstop since
That's
all
good.
This started.
Damn right.
We're the only ones out doing events,
started.
So it's
right.
been good. Yeah.
That's good. And you guys have been staying healthy the whole time, too.
Yeah.
No problem.
I hear you.
Yep.
We hear you.
Yeah.
Okay, we know. November 3rd, hurry up.
And then, boom, we get shut down.
Right.
Now we're okay at the moment. Right.
Oh,
Lawyer Wayne, greatest vampire of all time.
Twilight.
Oh,
no.
No.
Yeah, Edward Cullen.
Team Edward.
Head and Shoulders.
No.
Lay there and rest.
Lawyer Wayne?
Blade's only a half vampire, basically.
Yeah. What does that mean, Bay?
He's a half vampire.
Yeah.
Well, half
he got,
what?
He got out.
Half human, half
vampire. So just got one thing?
No.
How does that work?
No. He's got all the advantages of being a vampire with none of the disadvantages.
Yep.
He's overpowered. He can walk in daylight. He doesn't have to drink blood.
But he fights against it.
Yeah. If I were to go to this vampire, I would dress up Count Chocula.
Yeah. Okay. Love it. You should come.
Count Chocula would be mine. Right. Might be the creepiest vampire, that Count Chocula.
Actually, we did a poll in our events, having everyone post their favorite on-screen vampire, and Count Chocula came up.
You see that?
So, you know, it's going to be a little bit of every vampire you've ever seen on TV there.
I like it. Good for you guys. And hey, yeah, go get your blood sucked or something. Right?
That's awful.
I think it sounds better if you say, like, we bite, but not hard.
Yes.
You know.
We bite, but not hard.
Yeah. There you go.
The Count. The Count would be a good one.
I came up with thinking of a Dracula that... Yeah,
yeah,
that
the
guy.
Camp. One bloodbath. Right. Goes the Camp.
There is going to be a bloodbath, actually.
Yeah. Coach, what are you thinking? A vampire.
I couldn't even think of one.
Come on.
I'm serious. Y'all know I didn't have no cable growing up. So.
No, you know what? He had no cable growing up. That is true. That is true. Ryan.
You can't even think of the sexy vampires.
Lost Boys.
Lost Boys.
There we go.
Oh, yeah. Adam Joseph with Lost Boys. Adam, yeah. Lost Boys was good.
I know some witches, though.
Yeah, you know some witches, yeah. Mellissa, vampire, what do you got?
I got nothing.
No, come on.
Nothing.
Did we cover
not a lot
more?
Of vampire fans in the room today, apparently.
I'm
not a vampire fan.
You haven't seen any vampire movies?
Honestly, not a single one.
Wow.
I know. If I had a tail, it would be between my legs. I'm sorry.
I'll just name them all for you guys.
Yeah, what else? What other vamps you got?
Celine from Underworld.
Okay.
One of my favorites.
All right. What's Underworld?
Okay,
don't get offended.
Vampires versus lycans.
Sonya just clutched her pearls.
Well, it's the battle of the werewolves and the vampires.
Oh, yes, yes, Underworld.
It's good modern age, yeah.
Queen of the Damned.
Queen of the Damned was. Yeah, Queen of the Damned was good.
Yeah.
Queen of the Damned, that was what's her face?
Aaliyah.
Yeah.
Not what's her face.
Yeah, so. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, babe. It is Aaliyah.
Better movie than you'd think it would be.
Who we found out in real life is not a real vampire.
No.
Because she died.
Yeah. Right. Allegedly.
Oh. Allegedly. Yeah. That was that plane crash.
You got to let the right one in, both the original Swedish and the American version.
Yo.
Creepy little girl.
Who?
Let the right one in.
Yeah.
Good vampire movie.
Let me in.
Let me in. Yeah,
it was called, Let Me In, I think.
The American version.
Speaking of creepy little girls.
Friday Night. Friday Night was good. Thank you.
Interview with a Vampire.
Yeah.
Interview with a Vampire. That's the one I've been digging for.
Yeah. Brad Pitt and... Antonio
Banderas was the best in that. Of all the sexy vampires in Interview with a Vampire.
Oh,
Armand.
No, what's her name?
I got a couple.
Okay, what's the best movie ever, right?
Rocky.
No.
Yes. Rocky, absolutely.
Yeah. Rocky's a good one.
No. The Godfather.
It's the From Dusk Till Dawn.
Yes.
Okay. Oh, Tarantino.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Selma Hayek
dances.
That dance scene with the snake.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, I did that last year.
That was her performance last year. You're going to see some really inspired performances if you come to the Vampire Bowl.
And for those who really like vampires and The Office, I recommend What We Do in the Shadows. Both the movie and the TV series. It's kind of The Office meets vampires.
Awesome. So. No. Is it a comedy?
Oh, it's a comedy. Absolutely.
Oh, okay.
It's about what the vampires do in their day-to-day lives. It's hilarious.
That's great. Okay. I'll check that out. And checking IDs at the door will be Eddie Munster. So there you go. Definitely enjoy.
You've got Morticia from the Addams Family.
She was a vampire?
Was she a vampire?
She was.
I don't know, but let me tell you, she might be my favorite, though.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought she was a vampire because her dad was a vampire.
You know what? She has to be a vampire because Eddie Munster's a... Or is Eddie Munster a werewolf?
He's a mix of a werewolf and a vampire.
The Munsters and the Addams Family are different shows,
Shouldn't
first
Eddie
of all.
Munster...
And no, she's
not
a vampire.
Oh, wait, I'm sorry. You're right.
Oh, okay. We're mixing it all,
But the mom on the Munsters might be...
That's a vampire.
Yes, I'm sorry.
Right, Morticia from the Addams Family is just creepy.
Grandpa Munster was a vampire.
Yeah. See, why was an Eddie Munster a combination of a Frankenstein and a...
There's been a lot of questions asked about that. Apparently, her husband never really thought to inquire into it.
You never saw the werewolf, did you, though?
No.
Bobby was the milkman.
Boy.
Like, I think the last one I can think of is, Van Helsing.
Bob.
Some people are going to come dressed as like vampire slayers, like we said, Blade and Buffy the Vampire Slayer. And
Castlevania. That's a good one.
Castlevania.
Yeah.
Nintendo.
That's a good one. They got a animated series out. That's pretty good.
Ever see the movie Forgetting Sarah Marshall?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Dracula musical!
Yes. Right. Yes.
Yeah. And if I see Van Helsing, I will kill him. Yeah. Great, great scene. Well, you ladies will definitely have a good time, and if people go there, they'll have a good time too.
Yeah.
Yes.
Nice job, ladies. Nice job. All right. Well, coming up, how will you rewrite the story of a naked South Nashville woman? Okay. Yeah, this one gets a little creepy. Well, she was grabbing the butt of the Mapco gas station manager. Yeah, we're going to find out your answers in today's local new Mad Libs. Next on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
This is Hannah Price with Voice of Choice. And oh my God, I'm here with the best interviewer I've ever met. Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
You know what I can't stand? When you have people in Clarksville saying that there is nothing to do. Not for nothing, you couldn't be any more wrong. And obviously, you've never been to O'Connor's Irish Pub. Right off of Exit 1. It's like an adult daycare center. I mean, you go inside, you got the food, you got the drinks, okay? You got the DJ, you got the stage, you got the live music, the whole bit. It's fantastic. They got pool tables in the back, dartboards, video games, UFC main events on the dozens of screens that are inside and out. Oh, and outside. They got the cornhole boards. They got the outdoor tiki bar. They got the outdoor DJ party. They got this huge, massive stage where they bring in the big names like Black Label Society and Puddle of Mud and Greta Van Fleet. The monthly bikini contests are great. And I'm even getting good at that beer pong. They got karaoke nights on Wednesday. Open 7 days a week. There's always something to do in Clarksville. O'Connor's Irish Pub, Exit 1. Absolutely.
Non-stop Vegas action has arrived. Oak Grove Gaming is now open. Experience a whole lot of Vegas fun, minus the flight, at Oak Grove Gaming. Spin and win big on over 1,300 of the latest and greatest games. Indulge and eat like a king at our four fantastic restaurants. Live it up at the lively bars and lounges. Conveniently located off I-24, exit 86, across from Fort Campbell. Just a quick spin away. Plus, now you can reserve your room for when our luxurious five-story hotel opens later this fall. For reservations and more exciting information, visit oakgrovegaming.com. That's oakgrovegaming.com. Oak Grove Racing, Gaming, and Hotel. So Vegas, so close. Must be 21. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
You're taking your family out to dinner, and out of nowhere, a distracted driver runs a red light. And now you're taking trips to the hospital to visit your loved one. With weeks of recovery ahead, you're looking for answers, and we can help. We live in this community and want to help protect you. Pete Olson Law, an injury law team that is compassionate and caring for you. Text Pete to 82149 for a free consultation. That's Pete to 82149. Pete Olson Law, injury attorney for Clarksville.
Need a great venue in Clarksville to throw a holiday party? Maybe a family celebration, conference, or business meeting. Hi, this is April Consulo of Office Now, Clarksville's premier event space, and we're proud to announce our beautifully renovated event rooms. They're perfect for small, intimate gatherings to large group settings. We at Office Now offer amenities to include a commercial kitchen, on-site chef, in-house DJ, tables and chairs, and plenty of parking, all at competitive pricing. We are taking reservations now for the upcoming holidays, so visit us at ClarksvilleOfficeNow.com, where Clarksville goes to party with a purpose. Absolutely.
Hey, this is Sonia, former U.S. team member on the gymnastics team and now a current tumbling and trampoline competitive coach at American Twisters. And I love the local news Mad Libs on the Joe Padula Show because it makes me laugh and it makes me think. Absolutely.
All right, a little behind, but I'll catch up. A lot of moving pieces here, but we'll make it work. Here we go. Well, we got now our local news Mad Libs. I want to see how you're going to finish this story here. It's about a Nashville woman from South Nashville who was grabbing the butt of the Mapco gas station manager.
Allegedly.
We have video.
Oh boy.
All right, and hey, don't forget to subscribe, click like, share the whole bit, leave your comments, type in your comments on how you think you should finish the story. All right, here's what I need. Ladies, I need a business you have gone to in your pajamas. Write down your answer. Okay, let's see. Adam, I need a hot and sexy female celebrity.
Ooh, okay.
Coach Chestnut, your favorite Halloween costume?
Probably the same as his answer.
Could be. That you dressed up as.
Oh, yes. That makes it personal.
Yeah. Favorite,
that's real personal.
Favorite costume you've ever had.
Yep, that you ever had.
We already know he's a ninja.
Mellissa, crime 411. Something you recently screamed out loud. Okay. Lawyer Kegel.
Stop it.
Lawyer Wayne.
Behave yourself. Yes.
Your best physical feature.
All right.
Okay.
His thumb.
His eyes.
Bay. Something a man would have. Okay. Let's see. Ladies. Okay, vampire ladies. A word used to describe something you don't like. Okay. Coach. Something that you feel. Oh, I'm sorry. That's for Adam. Something that you feel. Coach.
Neglected.
Perfect timing. Coach, something you don't want. All right. Mellissa, a sound an animal makes. Lawyer Wayne.
Yes.
Something that you did that you weren't supposed to do.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Bay. A place that you have been to and had a bad time.
Yeah, it was.
Okay, no. He goes, no.
Other than the Joe Padula Show.
That's right, yeah. Other than this show. Vampire ladies.
Yes.
A really big mistake that you've made besides coming on today's show. Okay. Adam, something that you would buy with a winning scratch-off lottery ticket. And Coach, the adult drink you consume the most. Okay, there you go. Now, let's fill in the blanks. So Saturday, in South Nashville, okay, Metro Police, they responded to a business that you have gone to in your pajamas?
Walmart.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Did you really? Why'd you go in your... Oh, you're one of those people.
That's tradition.
Late at night.
Yes, Sam.
It doesn't matter what time of day.
Okay.
All right, so yes. So the cops there, they go to... They respond to Walmart, okay? This was in response to a disorderly 44-year-old named a hot, sexy female celebrity.
Jennifer Lawrence.
Oh, Jennifer Lawrence. Okay, so Jennifer Lawrence is in Walmart. Okay. So she, Jennifer Lawrence, she was taking off her favorite Halloween costume. Coach?
McGruff the crime dog.
Yes. Jennifer Lawrence was in Walmart dressed as crime.
McGruff.
McGruff. You were McGruff?
Yeah, that was my
you
man.
Up like
you,
took that?
A, you took a bite out of crime?
Yeah.
So cute.
Nice. How kinky of you.
I think I had that for like 5 years.
And then the ninja was for the other four.
Yeah, that's when she went by no more customs.
If you got an intimate while wearing that, would it be doggy style?
It definitely. I definitely like
that. You said that.
Be a little rough.
Rough.
No, I don't do rough.
Rough.
If it's requested.
All right, so Jennifer Lawrence, okay? She's taking off her Crime the McGruff, Crime the Dog costume, and she gets naked, and she's now harassing customers by saying something you recently screamed out loud.
Stop hitting the dog with a Nerf sword.
Yes. Stop hitting the dog with a Nerf sword. She's just running around Walmart naked.
She's lost her mind.
How fitting. Yep. And then she was grabbing people inside the store as well. So Jennifer Lawrence, well, the store manager, okay, he stated that that Jennifer Lawrence grabbed his, your best physical feature.
His hands.
Yes.
I have beautiful hands.
Yes.
Well proportioned. I could be a hand model. They're not too big. The fingers aren't weird or anything. I have lovely hands.
So, yeah. So naked Jennifer Lawrence, who was crime... McGruff, crime dog.
Crime dog. Grabbing people's hands?
Just grabbing, yes, the manager's hands.
Oh.
Okay.
His thumb looked a little crooked.
Coach. All right, so... Well, and it also grabbing Yeah, also grabbing something a man would have. Bay.
His laugh cracks me up. Hey.
What'd you put, Bay?
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You, can I say it?
Mm-hmm.
Penis.
Yeah, okay.
He said, can I say it?
So she's first grabbing the manager's hand, and then she's grabbing the manager's penis.
I think we just skipped a few bases there, ma'am.
You know, Bay ain't into foreplay.
Yeah. He said, can I say it?
Well, the manager said that she grabbed it in a manner that was a word to use to describe something you don't like.
Janky.
What?
Janky.
Janky. Yes. Yeah, so naked Jennifer Lawrence is grabbing the manager's hand and penis. Okay, and the manager said that it was janky. Okay.
Oh, janky penis.
Janky
penis. I think
penis.
He was my neighbor.
Boy.
Mr. P, how you doing?
Janky. All right, well, it said the manager, after she was grabbing the hand and the penis, and it was janky, it made him feel something that you feel.
Happy?
Yes, it made the manager feel happy. I don't even know why he called the cops.
I don't know either. Naked
janky. Jennifer Lawrence is janking.
Never mind.
That's a different film.
Yeah, that's a different, yeah. Yeah. Well, it made him feel, yes, happy. And the touching was something you don't want.
Taxes.
Yes. Yes.
But it was taxing, I guess.
So it made him feel happy, and the touching was taxing.
Taxing.
Yeah, it was taxing.
That's too much.
Well, she was the lady. It was the manager said that she was making Jennifer Lawrence was making noises that were okay. All right. So while she's with the hand, with the penis, happy. And she was making noises that were okay.
What animal is that in?
That's a goat, right?
Oh, okay.
Sure. Yeah. Could be. All right. Well,
hog.
That's when the manager instructed Jennifer Lawrence to stop and leave the store. Mm. And after multiple times, Jennifer Lawrence was informed that she was. Something that you did that you weren't supposed to do.
Snuck drinks into a movie theater.
Yes. Yes. The manager is saying, stop it. You can't sneak drinks into this movie theater.
That's right.
Right.
At a Walmart.
At a Walmart.
Just with drink. A Nerf sword and hit the dog.
Yeah.
It must have been a super Walmart. That's
just drinks. That's like a whole meal.
Yeah.
Police observed her walk away, though, and immediately back into the store. Still naked, Jennifer Lawrence was. She said that she had to go get her clothes. But that's when she was taken into a place that you've been to and didn't like or had a bad experience.
Court.
Yes.
Right. You had a bad experience.
Yes. She was taking it right into court, naked. They're just like, listen, we're bringing you right. The judge has got to see this. We got Jennifer Lawrence naked. Her hand's tired, but yes.
Janky.
Janky. She was charged with sexual battery. Criminal trespass, and a really big mistake that you've made.
Having one too many drinks.
Yes, yes, illegal. Yeah, why are we drinking so much?
You don't have to answer that.
I'm not going to answer.
Okay. There you go.
Lawyer Wayne on it.
On advice of counsel.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Lawyer Wayne.
You don't have to listen to the lawyer all the time, okay? I was so close. All right, so, well, yeah, she remains, Jennifer Lawrence, she remains jailed in lieu of a bond of something you would buy with a winning scratch-off lottery ticket.
Another lotto ticket.
Yes, her bond is another lotto ticket. Right.
That works.
That's all you got to do. Here's a scratch-off. Good luck.
Keep it rolling.
Yeah.
Another free ticket. Keep it rolling. Gotta keep going.
The report also stated that she smelled like the adult drink you drink the most.
Long Island iced tea.
So that's what it was.
Fancy.
Shout out to my bartender at Chili's.
All those Long Island
iced
teas.
Hour.
Chili's.
They hit you
baby
hard.
Baby back ribs.
That's my girl.
Do you want to see what she looks like?
Yep.
Jennifer Lawrence.
Jennifer Lawrence, okay.
Yeah. You want to see what Jennifer Lawrence looks like?
She's the girl from like Mockingjay and
yes.
Catching Fire yes. and all that.
There she is.
Wait, that's a that's woman?
Pull this up.
What? I looked up. I wasn't paying attention, and I heard a woman, and I saw.
Yeah, the rough life,
thick
bro.
Chin.
Yeah.
Her chin is very well defined.
She's smiling.
Because she got them Long
how
Island.
How do you hair?
time for years.
Is this the thing for the for Hunger Games?
Like, yeah.
Look at them eyes. You know, she's bored of drinking.
That's no underbite.
It's a lot of Long Island iced teas. Eyes. Look at
somebody
that.
Said Bay is 12 today.
Oh, happy birthday, Bay. Nice.
Happy birthday.
We get cupcakes.
Birthday.
All right. Well, we gotta like play it safe, and we gotta wrap it up here. All right. So, Lawyer Wayne, what'd you learn on the show today?
Learned that they're having a vampire party.
Yes.
Yeah. And any kind of
vampire. Just up like a vampire.
Are invited.
Right.
Especially Twilight vampires. Put your glitter on.
Come on, Edward.
Count Chocula. Do it.
Count Chocula.
Right? Not Eddie Munster, though. That's werewolf. We
that's a werewolf, yeah.
You can
that's
come werewolf. As a werewolf, though.
Ooh. Yeah?
Yeah.
But you can't enter the
all
vampire.
All the vampires will right. hiss right. at you.
Right. It is a full moon on Saturday, though.
It is. It's a blue moon.
That's right.
Second full moon yes. in October. And it's 2020.
Yeah.
Scary times.
Right. It's perfect.
I'm not feeling it.
It's perfect time for it.
I know. Coach is going to be drinking his Long Island iced tea. He's all set for it.
Take that crime dog McGruff, whatever it's called. Take that costume, turn it into a werewolf costume.
McGruff.
Go on down to the.
That was the man back in the day.
Go as down. McGruff to the party.
I would, but I got to hit ATL. As soon as I leave here, I'm on the road.
Ah. Mm. ATL's slang for Atlanta.
Hotlanta.
Hotlanta.
Hotlanta. Hotlanta. Yeah. It is warm there.
Envy, what'd you guys learn? What stood out on the show today? I know you guys missed some of it, but. One thing that stood out.
Besides that lady's hair.
Yes, besides that. Yes, that lady's hair stood out today.
That lady's hair did
that's pretty
out.
Good.
I don't know if those were drinking eyes on that lady.
No,
or not,
no. I'm sure there were some other things involved. Ryan, nice job today. Nice job. Good work. Coach, what'd you learn on the show today?
I learned that all women don't know what Kegels mean.
Yes, not oh all God, women yes. know what Kegels are.
I thought that they did.
That is some homework for you later.
Yeah.
Did someone send you anything or? No, no good.
That could really enhance your.
You really still don't know what it is? Ooh. Alexa,
stop.
Don't do it.
What's
don't do
Kegel?
It. Alexa, stop.
God, I feel like I'm on a different show.
No, Kegel. You're on the right show.
One, as a noun. A contraction of the pubic occipital muscles, performed for the purpose of strengthening them. Two, as a verb, to clench one's perineum and pelvic
what?
Muscles.
By you're all up.
You can use your device to instantly connect with your other household Echo devices.
Okay. Oh! All right.
You tell can everybody.
All connect right. your vaginal wall.
Now, Melissa has to look up what a perineum is. Like.
I didn't know that was the official name for that.
Alexa.
Yeah, it's the space between...
Alexa, show me Kegel.
Oh, Joe.
Are you trying to shop for Kegel?
No. I am not shopping for Kegels. Mellissa Marquais, Crime 411. What'd you learn on the show today?
Y'all are idiots. No, I'm kidding. I learned that Kegels are not everybody battle. Really understands the depth of why women stay or men stay in abusive relationships.
Yes, mm-hmm. yes. We went into
we need
that
to
pretty
really
good. Yeah.
Get that info out. And don't judge people because they're in an abusive relationship. Mm-hmm. It's not always as easy as you think to leave.
Well said. I didn't think we were going to have that conversation. I did not foresee that conversation coming, but I'm glad it happened. It was important. Nice job today.
Thank you.
Good work.
Appreciate you.
Bay?
Yes.
Wait, did we get a Adam? Did we get you?
No.
What did we learn on the show today?
That I'm always being neglected by
no,
you right now.
I'm sorry. I'm not used to you here on Fridays.
I know, it's weird.
It's right. I'm getting used to it.
Yeah, there you go.
But yeah, what stood out for you?
Two things. One, learned about a vampire event that I did not know about.
Second annual.
Me being the horror buff that I am, you know, wearing my fly shirt.
You got it.
And then two, that you like janky things.
Yes. Yes, janky.
Yes.
Janky.
Matt in the comments, well, he says that he learned
what
that I make good goat noises. So
yes.
There you go.
Oh, there you go.
That's ridiculous.
If you do it right, you can get a Kegel exercise. Right?
I'm done with that.
No wonder why he stole your car. No wonder why he tried to hide your car on you.
I'm so lost.
Never mind. Bay, what'd you learn on the show today?
The 15 euro.
Yes. That was a hell of a story, man.
Crazy.
And you try and put yourself in that shoes. You know, you see your mother getting abused by your father. What would you do after over and over again? So we'll see what happens. All right. And what did I learn on the show tonight? I learned that, a lot of people on the list here in Montgomery County.
Right.
Yes, that was surprising.
A lot of people on the list.
A lot of blue dots.
A lot of blue dots out there.
And not blue checks.
Nope. Those are not verification checks. It's not the check you want.
I think the number one thing on that list should have been stay away from the kids. Like,
yeah, hello.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Don't dress like this. No, but stay away from children.
You definitely should check that list before you buy a house.
Yeah. 6 p.m. curfew.
I wonder why they can't have Halloween decorations.
Because it might entice the kids.
Because it attracts kids to come to the house for candy. Yeah. If the light's off, then they know that it's like... What doesn't matter.
Not what about religion?
Not these greedy kids.
No? What about religion?
What about it?
What if that's their religion?
Oh, like if they're a Satan worshiper or something. Mm-hmm. These are not Halloween decorations. I keep these up all year. It's part of my culture and heritage.
Like golf?
Uh-huh. Yeah. Like golf.
I can't say.
Goth.
Goth.
Goth. Halloween. I'm just a goth.
I'm just into golf. I just
hole in one.
No. Goth.
Two, yeah, three like holes.
Like those would be your indoor fishnet decorations. There was one person that decorated their house and it looked like an absolute horrific murder scene. Like the whole driveway was blood. And like, did you see that?
I
and
did.
So
I,
many
I
people called it, the yeah. cops on the people because they thought it was like a real crime scene. It was amazing. I mean, it was nasty, but it was great.
I've seen that in a girl I was dating's bathroom. Ugh. It was everywhere.
Oh, Joe.
All right, I had to. It's a Friday. I
had Were you dating to. Carrie?
Like, had what? To go there.
She should have called it Carrie. Yeah.
No, Joe. What day of the month was it?
Tuesday.
Nah, I'm just kidding.
That's not that kind of bloodbath.
Well, Joe loved them $90 dates.
Great show, everyone. Thanks for coming.
All right.
Joe, but only 3 to 7 days out of the month, fast. He likes those dates.
All right, but we do got to have a great, safe Halloween, okay? Don't forget, you got daylight saving time, okay? And, yeah, we get to put those clocks back an hour.
Oh, no.
Yeah,
I forgot about that garbage. It's going to be dark at 4:15.
Yeah. Sunday at 2 o'clock.
Oh, I hate it so bad.
1 o'clock.
So depressing.
Yeah. More time to 1 o'clock. Out.
Yeah, Sunday at 2 o'clock, which will be 1 o'clock.
What if we all just said, no, we're not doing it?
I would love for some candidates to step forward and say one of the issues that we're going to fix.
Tennessee already passed it.
It's daylight savings time.
They just can't enforce it.
They need to do it federally. The federal government needs to sign off on just getting it done.
Well, then they just need to sign it because I'm over dark at 4:30. It's annoying.
2024.
I hate it. Does anybody else hate it?
We need to make that the issue.
Make that the issue?
Yeah.
Daylight savings time.
7 o'clock in the morning anyway.
I hate it so bad.
I work tomorrow, so I really don't.
You guys know why I'm all for daylight saving time, right?
Why?
Because the countries the majority of the countries that don't observe daylight saving time are poverty friggin' crap holes.
Yes.
I don't want to be a part of that.
Secret to our success.
Well, they say that.
Daylight save. We save all that daylight.
There's a rumor that says that the reason they won't change it and make it so that you don't have to change it back is because if it's dark, more people will go shop and spend money. Because they can't go outside and do stuff.
Right, I'm like, if you got money, you're going to shop.
Just leave it alone.
Next time on Joe Padula Show, daylight savings time.
DST.
Yeah, your name.
Amazon is open 24/7.
Thank you, Amazon.
All right, we got to get out of here. Have a great, safe weekend.
Happy Halloween.
See you again. And thank you for allowing us, enabling us to have a conversation, your conversation here on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
It's the Joe Padula Show.
Bada bing.
Clarksville's conversation.